Welcome! I am Emir, and let's look back in hindsight. This video is part of a long series. Bitin Serie, Fair Use Saga, Linux Mint Saga. To watch the full video, click the link on the end screen or in the description. Thank you. Chapter 3. Mintify Frenzy. 5 months after Elisa came 6th Felicia. Get it? Felicia? Feliz Navidad? Heh, fake news. Felicia simply meant the happy one, not happy Christmas. Felicia was supposed to come out on November. The Christmas 2008 release was based not on Elisa, but on Ubuntu 8.10 Intrepid Ibex, released in October 2008. This codebase was 2 years newer than Elisa's, which could be traced all the way back to Ubuntu 6.10, EGF, from October 2006. From Felicia, Mint would be built on the latest Ubuntu codebase instead of the previous Mint release. But, as I said in my What Doomed Longhorn video, a reset does not mean starting from scratch. The Mint team announced that it was 1. Automating the porting of the technology to Mintify Ubuntu, and 2. Focusing on research and development, as well as the design of desktop utility instead of the base system. By using its own LSB, Linux Standard Base Information, Mint no longer called itself Ubuntu. But what about what made Linux Mint? Well, Linux Mint. First, Mint Update 3, which came with update history, support for proxy connections, and other changes. As for the UI, dun 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 dun. But if you close your eyes, hey, where does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? Mint Upload, developed with newbies in mind, now had FTP support for experienced users. However, contrary to the Mint philosophy of ease of use, no comfort. The Mint Upload GUI did not support adding a service. Second, Mint Nanny, a domain blocker, and only a domain blocker. Useless if the child knew GMG, the IP address of some spicy website. It also didn't block subdomains. So, even if you block linuxmint.com, the block did not cover the forums, nor the blog. That take that on Facebook though. Terminal got new commands, which still work in modern day Mint. First, app content. shows a list of and the location of the components of a package, software, or program installed using apt-get or a dev package. Flatpak's not included though. Also, no config files, which would be useful after removing an app. Does Windows or macOS have app content? Second, app contains could identify what packages use files with the name searched for. It could be used to find out if a program used an unknown sketchy file. Surely, that's not a problem in Linux. The Penguin OS does not get viruses. No malware. Right? Finally, search is a keyword search tool. But why do I keep getting binary file matches? Mint for Win could run Mint as a virtual machine on Windows. Ease of use, no comfort, is one thing. Mint for Win isn't it. More like a test drive, which did not even show Mint at its fullest. Better to just boot the Mint ISO or install Mint on a separate partition. Some UI changes. Open as root would now run on the same Explorer, Nautilus, instead of getting a whiplash. The menu icon and search command could be configured in Mint Menu version 4.1. Giver was a proto Warpinator. Finally, a staple of current Mint, GUFW, GUFW, the firewall configuration tool. The Lite Edition became the Universal Edition. The name change reflected the new aim of bringing a localized live system to non-English speaking users, such as Pinoy Ako, Pinoy Tayo, to get users of the Bayanihan Linux distro, maybe. Felicia also had the usual community editions and X64 edition. Felicia was the first KDE CE using KDE 4. Here is a review of Felicia from 29 December 2008. It is not lost media. Not yet. Mint saw growth in everything except income, which was a Hawaiian roller coaster ride. Must be because of the global financial crisis. Mint's first, and certainly not the last. 7. Gloria, not the small lady, went gold on 26 May 2009, 5 months after Elisa, and was based on Ubuntu 9.04 Jonti Jackalo, released a month before. Mint Menu could finally be opened by pressing the Super, Windows, and the left control keys at the same time. To get that true Windows experience, the Super key alone could be set to do that. Can you set another keyboard shortcut in Windows for opening the Start menu? By default, pressing either Super or Escape closes the Mint menu. It also got a search box, which debuted in or was backported to Felicia X64. Suggestions would appear if error 404 not found. Again, looks familiar? About that, Clem said that Vista's menu was, quote, extremely different in both its layout, what it lets the user achieve, and how one can interact with it, end quote. Meanwhile, Mint Menu was, quote, not only geared towards novice users, but also towards experienced ones, end quote. Menu items had descriptions on by default. On Mint Cinnamon today, they appear on hover. Clem lamented that these menu features were not well known. Favorites used to be empty by default. Not anymore. Before, the codename was part of the Mint menu button. In Gloria, the release version and edition would appear only when the cursor is hovering over the Mint menu button. This also appears to have debuted in or backported to Felicia 64-bit. Before Gloria, the trash icon looked the same, whether empty or full. Wait, can virtual trash even be full? In Gloria, but also in Felicia 64-bit, the trash icon would update. Kind of late to the party there, Mint. If this does not work on the Gloria Live CD, have you tried logging off and logging on again? Trash could also be cleared using the Windows treatment. Mint update now showed the download size of packages, as well as the changelog for Mint packages. A different icon would appear if updates were available. No more blinker. A mainstay of modern Mint first appeared in Gloria. Mint Welcome, replacing the Mint homepage on Firefox. Mint Assistant got the boot. Mint Upload got a redesign. Goodbye ads. A service manager, embracing ease of use. No comfort, as well as support for SCP and SFTP. Mint Desktop, though, a downgrade. Two new terminal commands, apt version to get the version number of an installed program. Because opening the Synaptic Package Manager is just a hassle. And RTFM, GMG. No new fortunes though. Only Fluxbox did not get the Gloria treatment. Shane stepped down due to personal reasons. This did not mean the end of the Fluxbox CE. For you see, we are at our best when we step up. Kendall Weaver stepped up. During the development of the next Mint version, Clem did what Emir's Bitten did from December 2019 to August 2021. Paid support, again, became a revenue source. 8 Helena debuted on 28 November 2009, 6 months after 7 Gloria. Helena was based on Ubuntu 9.10 Karmic Koala, released a month earlier in October 2009. The Mint team deleted the Mint name of the Mint tools. I wonder how much the marketing department got paid for that brilliant name. I'll keep calling them that. Mint still does. The lock screen button became a part of Mint menu. Menu settings allowed disabling default items and changing the location of the Mint home folders, which I wish Nemo and the menu in today's Mint Cinnamon could. You could, but not the easy way. When I was using 21.2 Victoria, the downloads folder, for some reason, moved to the music folder. So, I moved downloads back to home. But, when I clicked the downloads link on the sidebar in Nemo, an error said that the downloads folder did not exist. Error 404, erased out of existence. I don't know how I fixed it, but it was not through the Mint menu. Mint update got a pack of updates. Updateception. Columns could be hidden and the window resized. By using Synaptic, update progress and any errors became visible. Problems would appear in the main window. The software sources tool in the edit menu would allow the user to choose where to get updates, called repositories. The user could also choose mirrors. The closer the mirror, the faster the download time. Finally, packages could be ignored because, quote, upgrading is never safe, unquote. Mint upload bade goodbye. I hate to see you go, but have a good time. Two apps swoop in. The upload manager for setting up the FTP of choice and the file uploader for uploading files to that FTP. This
was a step back.
Helena's boot sequence was a whiplash. But this was not the main team's fault. Other changes are on screen. Pause to read. Helena got the usual additions with two new CEs, LXDE and KDE64. The Mint 2009 Christmas gift was the Linux Mint Community Portal. It would evolve into a venue for sharing ideas, hardware, software, reviews, and tutorials, even hosting users' mini-blogs, a throwback to how Mint started. Today, the community portal hosts software reviews, beta testing, and statistics on Mint users per jurisdiction. Much of the community engagements moved to GitHub. However, as of writing, and even in 2010, the Mint forums existed, not Lost Media, despite two close calls. For me, the community portal seems redundant. Bonus subchapter, Software Manager. The Software Manager, Mint Install, would be a source of pride for the Mint team because it was among the first, if not the first, of its kind, beating the App Store and Play Store. Or not. Mint Install even inspired Ubuntu. Maybe citation needed. That caused bitterness with the Mint team. But still, they acted with grace. Remember, the idea of a software manager is not copyrightable. The expression, the GUI, the code, is. Nothing is original. Nothing comes from nothing. The name cannot be copyrighted. But it can be trademarked. Recall Barbie the copyright versus Barbie the trademark? The software manager first appeared as a Mint Install offline front-end in 6 Felicia. This looks like the React OS Applications Manager. The Linux Mint software portal would remain the online front-end. Both would be in sync through XML metadata, which also made possible syncing Mint Install with compatible third-party portals. The evolution of the software manager could be best summed up ironically. Quote, "The more things change, the more they stay the same." End quote. 7 Gloria. Another GUI update. Information was pushed into a separate window. And the featured applications window was added for popular apps that were not yet installed. Back when Opera and Skype were cool.
and some other changes. 8. Helena. More design changes. Plus, it allowed installing and removing multiple applications in one click. This feature made its way thanks to feedback. Other changes on screen. Taking the DeLorean for a spin. 9. Isadora. Software manager reset. Though, still connected with an online portal. At this point, the Linux Mint community website. User reviews posted on one would appear on both. Some more updates. 10. Julia. New icons and subcategories for the internet section. 11. Katya. New splash screen, home screen, UI, fonts category, and more. The tumult after Katya would lead to a pause on software manager development. We'll get to future software manager changes once Mint sorts Cinnamon out. For now, gotta get back in time. Let me know what you thought of this video. Comment below. Please like and share this video on social media. Subscribe and ring the bell. Watch all Emir's Biten. /inhindsight. Support the show on Patreon, on PayPal, or through crypto. Thank you to my sibling G-G Arts for my avatar. Check out and support her work by clicking the links in the description. To watch the full video, the link should come up here on the end screen now. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and take care.